In this Game Workshop tutorial, we're going to isolate a vintage car from its background. And we will see some tips and tricks to make the car look better. Right-click on the image in your image folder and go to Open With. Here we can click on GIMP. If you want to follow along, there is a download link for the image in the video description. When the image is opened, we go to View, Zoom, and Fit Image in Window. Right-click on the layer and click on Add Alpha Channel. The font changes from bold to normal, which indicates that this layer can now have transparency. Go to the toolbox and click on the Configure tab icon. Then on Tool Options menu and on Reset All Tool Options. Click Reset. First, we are going to select the outline of the car, making the toolbox the Parts tool active. In the top of your screen is a link to a simple and short tutorial about the Parts tool. Zoom in and out by holding the Control key and then rolling the mouse wheel. Usually, selecting works best when we stay just a little bit inside the boundaries of our subject. When we hold the spacebar and then move the mouse, we can pan the image. With Ctrl-Z, we can undo one or more previous made notes. Make sure not to forget the antenna. We will go fast forward until the point where we close the path. Close the path by holding the Control key and then clicking the last node over the first one. Now we can work on the windshield. Here we have to make three different paths because of the antenna and the rear view mirror. And after the windshield, we make a path between the upper and lower part of the bumper and just above the bumper. When all paths are made and closed, we press Ctrl-Shift-J to maximize the image in the window. Then we hit the button Selection from Path to make the selection. Now click on a random tool in the toolbox to make the path invisible, or just press the B key so the Parts tool is still active. Go to Select and click on Invert. We've now selected the background instead of the car. The marching ends at the edge of the selection shows that it is selected. Go to Edit and hit Clear to remove the background. Back to Select and now to None to deselect the selection. When we have isolated the car, we are going to remove some bluish reflections in the chrome areas. We start with making a path around the Rolls-Royce emblem on the radiator. Then we go to the top of the radiator. After that, we make paths around all four headlights. And finally, we make paths around the four different parts of the front bumper. Don't forget to close each path before proceeding to the next one. And again, we go fast forward. When this is done, we press Ctrl-Shift-J again. Hit the button Selection from Path. And then press the B key again to make the path invisible. Now we go to Colors in the menu bar. Desaturate. And in the flyout menu, we click once more on Desaturate. In the dialog box, we can just hit OK. Press Ctrl-Shift-A to deselect. With this technique, we have cleaned our chrome from color casts. In the next step, we will make tinted glass in the windshield. Click on the new layer button. Rename it windshield. Make the fill width transparency. And click OK. Make a path around the windshield. Make in the toolbox the Paths tool active. Here we must make two paths because of the antenna. When both paths are made and closed, click the foreground of the foreground background button. Fill in the HTML notation 6 D 8 4 9 and 8. Then hit Enter. This should give us a bluish gray color. Click OK. Hit the button Fill Path. Make sure solid color is checked. And click Fill. Now we can hit the B key again, which makes the paths once more invisible. Make the opacity of the windshield layer about 40 or 50, or whatever looks good to you. On the left front mudguard, we will do something about the reflection of the windows and the houses. Activate the car layer. Make a path around the area that you want to remove. Then click on Move in the tool options. Move the path by click and drag to an area that you want to use as fill. Click on Selection from Path. Go to Select and hit Feather. We feather the selection with 15 pixels and click OK. Go to Edit and click Copy and back to Edit and now to Paste as New Layer. Double click on the name of the new layer and rename it Mudguard Fill. Hit Enter. Make the Move tool active. Check the option Move the active layer. Now click and drag the mudguard fill over the area that you want to make invisible. Press Ctrl-Shift-A to deselect the selection. Make the smudge tool active. We can now, with the default settings, smudge the edge of the mudguard fill a bit like so. And Ctrl-Shift-J once more. We will continue with making the license plate invisible. Click the New Layer button. Name this layer License Plate. The fill width should still be transparency. And we click OK. We make the Path tool active again. And check the option Design. Make a path around the area of the license plate like so. Hit the Selection from Path button. Then we can click on the foreground color to make the color palette visible. This time we fill in the HTML notation 8, A, 8, A, and 8, A. Hit Enter. We go to Edit and hit Fill with Foreground Color. Then we fill in the HTML notation D, 4, D, 4, and D, 4. Hit Enter again and click OK. Make the paintbrush active and choose brush hardness 0.25. We make the opacity about 60. Click in the image just above the license plate. Then hold the Shift key and click just below the license plate to make a straight diagonal line like so. Repeat this 2 or 3 times like shown in the video. Now we can press Ctrl-Shift-A to deselect and Ctrl-Shift-J. To finish off, we're going to make a shadow below the car. Make a new layer, name it Shadow, and click OK. Then we hit the downwards pointing arrow several times until the layer is at the bottom of the layer stack. Click on the Free Select tool. Now we can draw the shape of the shadow below the car. Click the last node over the first one, and then we double-click inside the selection to confirm. Go to Select, Feather, and feather the selection with 50 pixels. Click OK. Reset the foreground background colors to their default by clicking the little squares. And again, we go to Edit and hit Fill with Foreground Color. Press Ctrl-Shift-A. We reduce the opacity to about 70. We can make another new layer. Name it Background. And make the fill white. Click OK. By clicking the downwards pointing arrow one time, we place this layer at the bottom of the layer stack. Now we can click this layer off and on to see how our isolated car looks, but be sure to make it invisible before exporting the image. And one last remark.
when you export your final image out of GIMP, it has to be done as a PNG file. Otherwise, there will be no transparency. And there we have our isolated car. I hope you have a good time with this tutorial and that it helps you. Please take a moment to give it a thumbs up and to post your comment. Thank you very much for watching.